Yes, friends. Hello, everyone. In this lesson, we will talk about industrial automation. We will discuss the contactor, one of the most important and indispensable equipment in the field. What is a contactor? How does it work? And how is it shown in a circuit? We will answer the questions together, friends. Briefly explain what it is. To mention an industrial switching, friends, we can call it an element, that is, a small voltage signal with a larger one. We use contactors to control a load operating with voltage and current. We can do it with friends. Yes, if you want, let's examine it together. Friends, first of all, we have three main mansions. Friends, the input leg names in the contactor are L1, L2, and L3. The output leg, their names are T1, T2, and T3. Friends, this is ours. Our three main hosts, that is, the contacts to which we connect the load we want to control. We can say friends. Yes, if this is the circuit symbol. The electrical circuit symbol is shown as the three open main contacts on the left. We do this with our friends, L1, L2, L3, input phases, and T1, T2, T3, from the contactor. Our output phases. Then, we have an auxiliary contact. Friends, as you can see, it says no on this auxiliary contact, so it is normal. Open means this is our open contact, and this is our auxiliary open contact. We can control any extra load. So, yes, this is the circuit symbol, with the representation of a single open contact. It is done like this. Friends? No. An input. Leg 13. Output. The leg is called 14 in the circuit. Yes. Later. The coil part of our contactor to which we connect our control circuit. Friends, there are A1 and A2 contacts. This is the signal required for our remote control. We have coils to which we give the required voltage. And the circuit symbol is EEAs on the right. The coil sign is the basic principle of the contactor. Friends, dot friends. When we give the necessary voltage to this coil, there are three main. We check our contact and one auxiliary contact. This is the open three, when the required voltage is applied to the main contact, and auxiliary contact A1 and A2IT becomes closed, and the loads we connected start working, my friends. The working principle of our contactor is also like this. Friends. Yes. How do we connect the contactor in a physical circuit? If you want, let's examine it together. First of all, we have a network, friends. We need the voltage of the load we want to control with the contactor. By passing it over the mains voltage in this way, we provide the connection for our one control circuit after 380 volts. Friends, we have the necessary power supply. That is, 24 volts. The control circuit. Our power supply required for 24 volts is then used to stop the system. One stop and one start to give the first trigger to the system. We will need the button. Friends. Later we want to check something, friends. This could be our three-phase asynchronous motor. This could be a load. We placed it like this first in the network, friends. I need to connect three phases in voltage to the three main contacts of my contactor. I take the L1 phase and enter the first L1 leg of the contactor, and from here, I get the output.
I connect engine from the ignition. Friends, then connect the L2 phase. I enter the second contact of the main contact. Friends, then the L3 phase is also I enter the third contact of the contactor like this. Yes, it comes from the network. I connected the three phases to the input of the three main contacts of the contactor, and then to the three main outputs. I made the connection to my three-phase asynchronous motor from the contact. This is my friends. I have a power circuit. I connect the load I want to control. Part is my power circuit for me friends. Yes, for the control circuit, I exit the 24-volt power supply, plus again and enter my stop button. Friends, I am jumping from the stop button to the start button, then exit the start button, and turn on the contactor to send the necessary trigger to A1. I'm entering the A1 coil leg, friends. Yes, right now my 24-volt. The connection from the plus side of my power supply to A1 was made. Then, this to complete the connection. Connect the A2 pin to the neutral of the power supply, i.e., 0 volt. Friends, right now my stop button is closed. It is a 24-volt contact. My signal goes through the stop button, and my start button is an open contact. My 24-volt signal is waiting here for you, friends. If you press the start button and trigger, when I send it, my 24-volt signal enters from the A1 pin. A2 will be completed to 0 volts, and the circuit will be completed, and my signal will be produced. The required voltage will be given to my coil. Then, when the required voltage is provided, my 3 main contacts and 1 auxiliary contact, friends, it will be in a closed position. For sealing, I will use this. I can use the auxiliary contact here. The input leg of the auxiliary contact is start. When I connect the start input to my output leg, it helps like this. By connecting the ignition in parallel with the starter, I have completed the sealing process. My goal here is to send the first trigger to the start button via A1. The circuit will be completed, and the normally open auxiliary host will become closed. Even if I take my hand off the start button later, the circuit continues to be completed through this open contact. My system will continue to work because it will continue. Yes, if you want, let's simulate this. I press the start button like this. When the circuit is completed via A1 and A2, my engine will start. It will work, friends. If I take my hand off the start button, the circuit will continue to be completed via this auxiliary contact. Even if, then when I press the stop button, I stop my system. Friends, yes, this physical connection is shown in the electrical circuit diagram. As you can see on the right side, friends, this part is the power circuit. My circuit, my diagram corresponds to the power circuit, and this part is my control circuit. Friends, if you want, let's match each one by one. First of all, I will match them. I had a mains voltage of 380 volts. This circuit has a 3-phase mains voltage. In the diagram, it is shown as L1, L2, L3, and 1 ground, friends. Later, I had 3 main mansions that I wanted to check. I made the connections of the load 3. My main contact is in the circuit diagram, like this, showing 3. My main input contacts are 1,3,5, and my output contacts are 2, 4, 6. Then I check the load, which is the motor, friends. This is my power. As seen here, we symbolize it. My circuit was my control circuit. Now, let's come to it. I had 124-volt signal phase. This phase is in the circuit symbol here. As you can see, I can show it in the form of a diagram. Then for my neutral connection, I put a lowest neutral connection in the circuit diagram. Like this. I draw like this. Then, my stop button is open. Since a contact is a closed contact, the circuit symbol is shown in this way. In the form of a contact, then the start button is an open contact, so the circuit is. The diagram is also shown in this way. And the final A's. My coil tips were friends. A1 and A2 legs. My coil part is shown in the circuit like this. Then E is normally open, which we connect parallel to the start for sealing. I had an auxiliary contact in the circuit, and I connected it to the open contact in parallel with the start. We show it by connecting it as friends. Yes, the one on the left is mine. There is a diagram where the physical connections for the contactor are made. Friends, right? On the side is the symbolized form of this in the electrical circuit drawing. Yes, we see the working principle and circuit diagram of the contactor. This is how it is connected. Friends, we have finished this lesson here in this way. We are going to meet in our next lesson as follows.